My name is Jimmy and welcome back to the Civil Technology channel. So today we discuss about the depth analysis of the painting world. So as a civil engineer, we all people know before starting any activity on a construction site, we have to know how much cost and what are the different materials involved in a particular type of activity. So we can complete that work within a time period very smoothly and under our budget too. Okay, so for that point of view, today we discuss the rate analysis of the painting work. So in this video, we very much detailed way show what are the different materials involved, like putty, primer, paint, what are the cost of each and every material, how much cost required for the labor work, all that things we can discuss very much in a depth. So keep watching this video till the end. So let's start. So here I take example of two room house. Okay, the plan of the house you can see on the screen. The dimension of each room is 10 feet by 12 feet, means your length is 10 feet and your width is the 12 feet. Some other specifications like wall height is 12 feet, door size and window size are given here. Okay. So if you read the plan carefully, both the rooms can involve two windows on the opposite side of the wall as well as one door on the front side of the room. So total three openings in each and every room here. So whenever we calculate the area of wall at a time, we have to take care of this. We have to deduct the area of this opening so we can get the net quantity of the painting area. So let us start the estimating the quantity of painting work first. So our first step is to calculate the area of each and every wall as well as the ceiling area on which we have to do the painting work. So here our two rooms, both the rooms dimensions and specifications are exactly same. So what we do, first of all we calculate the area required for one room and simply we double that area so we get the total area of the painting work. So let us start it. So wall number one, suppose this is our wall number one. So as we show in the plan, the length of this wall is 10 feet. So 10 feet multiply by height. So wall height is 12 feet. So 10 feet by 12 feet is the area of our wall number one. But as this wall containing one window, the size is 6 feet by 4 feet, so we have to deduct that opening so we can get the net area of wall number 1, that is 96 square feet. Likewise, we calculate the wall number 2. This is our wall number 2, whose length is 12 feet, so length is 12 feet, wall height also 12 feet, so 12 feet by 12 feet we can get 144 square feet of the wall number 2 wall area. But here also one window coming out, so we have to deduct that window opening area, so we get the net quantity of 120 square feet for wall number 2. Next we calculate the wall number 3. So wall number 3 containing one door, so length is 10 feet, height is 12 feet, so 10 feet by 12 feet we get the wall area, and deduct the door sizes we can get a 96 square feet of the net area. Likewise we calculate the wall number 4 also. By mistake here the typing error, actually this is the wall number 4. Okay, so wall number 4 height is 12 feet and length also 12 feet, so we get the 144 square feet of the wall number 4 area. Okay, as this wall do not contain any opening, so we do not have to deduct any area, so we directly get the wall area. Okay, so if you add all these quantities, you can get the total wall area. On that we have to do the painting work. But along with wall, we also have to paint the ceiling. So we have to calculate the ceiling area also. So ceiling area is nothing but your floor area. So simply just multiply the both the side of the room, that is 10 feet by 12 feet, you can get ceiling area 120 square feet. So now we can add all this quantity and we get the single room area, that is 576 square feet. So this much area painting we have to do in a one room. So here we have a two rooms, so simply just double this area, we get the total area of our painting work, that is 1152 square feet. Just note down this area somewhere in your copy, so for the calculations we can get this quantity. Okay, so this is our first step. Now second step is we have to find out the each and every material quantity. Okay, means how much putty we require for this much painting work, how much primer we require, how much paint we require. So likewise, every material have some specific coverage area. Based upon that we can calculate the materials quantity. Okay, so let's see the materials area coverage. So first is the putty. So if we apply the putty in a single coat, then it covers the 20 to 25 square feet of area in 1 kg. So here kindly note that we see every material coverage area in particular range. We do not give the particular value, because this all are the thumb rules. So depending upon your site conditions and rough surface of your wall and all, this coverage area will be vary. So for conservative sir, we can get a smaller value for our calculation purpose. So putty in single coat covers the 20 to 25 square feet of area in 1 kg of bag. If we apply putty in a double coat, then it covers the 12 to 12 square feet of area in 1 kg of bag. Similarly, for primer, single coat, it covers 100 to 150 square feet in 1 liter. And for paint, 1 liter covers the 80 to 100 square feet of area in double coat. So likewise, these are the area coverage of each and every material that require for the painting work. So based upon this, we can calculate for our example how much quantity required for putty, primer and paint. So kindly take a snapshot of this page or just note down somewhere, so for further calculation you can easily understand. So before calculating the area cover material quantity, let's understand the mechanism of the painting work, how this exactly work. So what we do, first of all we apply the first layer of the putty on a plastering surface. So this first layer fill the gaps which are present in the plastering work and give a proper surface. On that we can apply the further materials. So after that we applying the second layer of the putty. But before that, if you find out any undulation in between the first layer or the plaster work, you have to rectify those things and fill with the putty properly. After that only you can apply the second layer of putty. So proper hard surface you can get for the primer and a paint work, and also sufficient water absorption problem also solved there. Because what happen if during your plastering work, if you do not give a curing properly, then some cracks will be happen. There is a chances of your plaster layer absorb the water from the putty and some other layers. So in that case, you have to make sure before doing the painting work, properly apply the water for the curing on a plaster layer, right? So next is we apply the primer layer. So primer layer we apply in a single coat, but on some side you can apply in a two or three coat depending upon the site requirement and all, but normally apply in a single coat. Here you have to take care, primer is always a oil based layer. Why? That we discuss about after few minutes, why the primer is oil based. So after applying the single coat of primer, we apply the paint layer, first layer of paint, and then apply the second layer of paint. So why we require the paint in two layer? Because in a single layer your wall doesn't get the proper color whatever you want for your home. So proper taking the color of your wall, you have to apply the second coat on that, so proper color will appear on the wall surface. So now let's discuss why primer is oil based layer. So as we see here, first we apply the two layers of putty. So putty basically the water based layer, and paint is also a water based layer. So if we apply primer also as a water based layer, then what happen, the function of primer will be here compromised, and your putty and paint both are mixed together. So because of that, your putty takes water from the paint and some fade surface will be appear on your wall. You many times seen after doing the paint work, some spots and all that things appear on the wall surface. So that is because of this. If you use the primer as a water based layer, then these types of problems you can face in the painting work, and that will give a very bad effect. So for that purpose, always remember the primer will be a oil based layer, so which act as a proper barrier in between the putty and a paint layer. Okay. So this will be taken care very properly. Next, let's introduce some rates of material. Okay, so these rates will be vary based upon the location of your site and availability of materials and labels and all that things. So here I taking my site rate, this will be vary, and you can put your site rate here, and based upon that you can calculate the cost of the material. So putty, normally putty will ranges from 20 to 25 rupee per kg. Primer here have a cost 120 to 150 rupees per liter. Paint generally carry a 140 to 180 rupees per liter depending upon the color and the brand of the paint, and labor generally take a 6 to 8 rupees per square feet for the painting work. So these are the some basic rates right now on my location, and whatever your location rate, just take it down and based upon that calculate the cost. So let's calculate the quantity of each and every material for our example. So first of all, putty we apply in a double coat. So if you remember and noted down earlier, then you should know the total area on which we have to do the painting work, that is the 1152 square feet, and double coat putty covers the 10 to 12 feet square feet area. So just we divide the total painting area divided by the coverage area, so we can get the quantity of putty, that is 115.2 kg for our example. Simply just put this value in the table for further calculations. Next material is the primer, that is we apply in a single coat. So primer cover the 100 to 150 square feet of area, but for conservative side, we taken as a 100 square feet coverage area. So likewise, total quantity, total area divided by area covered by primer, we can get the quantity of primer, that is 11.52 liters. Put down in the table. Next material, paint. So paint we apply in a double coat as we seen, and it covers the 80 to 100 square feet area in 1 liter. So simply we get the paint quantity here as a 14.4 liter for our example. So likewise, we calculate all the materials, all the major materials quantity for painting work. Next come is the labors. So normally labors, number of labors will vary depending upon how much time you have to complete this work, how much time you have for a painting work. So this is basically the part of the project engineer. So here we do not get much details, so we don't go in much detail here, so just take as a none. Next, we calculate the rate of every material, means every material how much cost carry, so we can identify how much budget we have to put for the painting work. So for that, just we seen some basic rate for my side. So based upon that, we can calculate the rate of each material. Okay, so for conservative side, I take here higher value for rate analysis purpose. So for putty, I take 25 rupees per kg. Primer, I take as a 150 rupees per liter. Paint, I taken as 180 rupees per liter. And labor, I take a 8 rupees per square feet. So just multiply the quantity of each material and the rate of same, you can get the amount for each and every material as well as the labors. So here you can see labor takes a much amount compared to the other materials. Why? Because always labor take a higher amount in every construction activity. If you compare each and every activity in a construction site, you can see labor carry a more amount compared to the material involved in a construction work. So likewise, we calculate each and every material and labor cost. So just simply add all this amount, you get the total amount for your painting work, that is 16,416 rupees. But this is not the final value, because these are the major materials and major costs that involve for our work. But along with this, we require some brass, some other equipments and all that for the painting work. So for that I take one approximate value, that is lump sum value, that is 1,000 rupees. Yes, obviously it not carry this much amount, but for a safer side, I take a 1,000 rupees. So just add your all materials and labor charges with this additional lump sum value, you will get the final amount, that is 17,416 rupees. So this is the final cost for your painting work for the example we seen here now. So this way you can do the rate analysis or estimation work for the painting work. So hope you guys like this video, understand the concept of this estimation of painting work. So if you like the video, please share with your friends too. And if you came here for the first time, just subscribe our channel as well as press the bell button, so you will get notified for our future video. So thank you so much for watching.